Emotional eating food as a substitute for love. Hi everyone, my name is Elena Semenek. I'm an online psychologist and a life coach. This is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing because here I offer free self-development webinar where I teach you about relationship, money, self-esteem, weight loss, and many other topics that will help you to grow and get the most of your life. Today is a free webinar which is called Emotional Eating, Food as a Substitute for Love. Please write in the comment section where you're watching me from, how old you are. You don't have to write the exact age if you don't want to, but just let me know if you are in your 50s or your 20s. I'm asking this question because my advice will be different for a person in their 20s and for a person in their 50s. I would like to know more about you so I can prepare new self-development exercises that will help you to become happier and more successful in life. Let's start today's topic: food as a substitute for parental love. This is one of the main psychological reasons for overeating. Food is one of the easiest ways to hide our feelings of loneliness. People who did not receive enough love in their childhood have self-doubt and struggle with their self-esteem. If you did not receive enough love in your childhood from your mom or dad, or maybe they loved your sibling more than you, then your sense of self-worth might be low. You criticize yourself a lot and have huge expectations on yourself. This creates tension and constant anxiety. Food is one of the easiest ways to suppress those feelings and lower the anxiety. If you did not receive enough love in your childhood, or your parents favored your sibling, then as a child you felt that you are not good enough, or something was wrong with you. People who did not receive enough love in their childhood subconsciously expect that their partner or their own children will give them this love. They create expectations that are very hard to fulfill. They expect that their partner will love them unconditionally. And they expect that their partner will always be there for them, always be on their side, and will always support them. When a husband does not agree with his wife, she can become very emotional. She can feel almost like he betrayed her. Often, she might think that he's not the one. If her husband disagrees with her, she feels like she made a mistake when marrying him. People who did not receive enough love in their childhood are constantly looking for someone to fill that void. It can be their child, or their best friend, or their husband. Of course, the other person cannot fulfill the lack of parental love, which makes it even harder on the seeker. Often, people who did not have enough love in their childhood will pick a partner who can't give them the type of love they're looking for. Our psyche is looking for closure. That's why people who had a complicated childhood are more likely to end up in a toxic relationship when they grow up. So when our partners, our children, and our friends cannot replace this parental love, we are going for another option. It might be an alcohol, it might be smoking, it might be toxic relationships, or overeating. Food is one of the easiest ways to replace a lack of love. Food has flavors, and flavors can change our mood. When we eat more than we need, we usually eat unhealthy food because it has a complex flavor. When we talk about overeating, we know that we're not talking about eating too much broccoli or salad. Overeating is always related to fat, oily food, fried food, and sweets. We feel pleasure when we eat fatty foods. This feeling of pleasure helps us to compensate for feelings of loneliness and lack of love. It helps us suppress those feelings and refocus our brain on a pleasant sensation in our belly. If we did not receive enough love from our parents, then we will subconsciously expect it from our partner. Maybe our partner works a lot, or maybe he does not give us as much attention as we need. Maybe his love language is different from ours. Then we will look for something else. We will look for love somewhere else. A married person can look for a mistress. An unmarried person might switch partners often. Nobody will be good enough for him because nobody can replace the lack of parental love. Today, I would like to offer you a simple test that will help you to see if you received enough love in your childhood. Answer a simple question. The love between man and woman, is it a conditional or unconditional love? To make this question more personal, let me ask this in a more specific way. Do you want or do you expect your partner to love you unconditionally? If you answer yes, it means that subconsciously you want your partner to give you the type of love that you did not receive from your parents. It means that you are looking for a parental love from your partner. It means that emotionally you are not fully ready yet to be in a romantic relationship with another person. The love between a man and a woman is always conditional. If you want to have loving, caring, healthy relationships, then you should understand that rules, conditions, and responsibilities are the main ingredients of love. It may sound harsh, but allow me to explain. Every woman wants a partner who is responsible, brave, and emotionally mature. We women dream about a successful man who can protect us and provide for our family, who can be a great husband and a great father for our children. Every man wants a woman who is kind, a woman without drama, a woman who can support her man, a woman who can inspire her man, a woman with a big kind heart who will always bring joy to the relationship. All those things are conditions. We have responsibilities in relationships. We should listen to each other, we should think about each other. We should support and respect each other. All those things are rules of love. We also have deal breakers. In other words, conditions that will end our love. Conditions that will break our love, will end our relationship. For example, cheating, physical abuse, alcoholism, drug abuse, etc. Every person has his own deal breakers. When our partner does not meet our conditions of love, we begin to argue. When one partner does not follow the rules and the expectations of other, then the other partner will likely break the rules as well. As a result, we have two adults who can behave like children and devalue each other. Every partner has his own responsibilities in a relationship. When we fall in love, we follow all those conditions and rules. We even do more than expected. But within time, we forget about those things. If we did not receive enough love in our childhood, at some point we will demand it from our partner. We create drama, we can act childish, sometimes selfish, and we expect that our partner will love us unconditionally and accept our inappropriate behavior. We attract people in our life who are similar to us. If we are not emotionally or psychologically mature, then we will likely attract a partner who is on the same level. At the beginning, we play the roles of perfect partners for each other. At some point along the road of our relationships, we stop our game of the perfect couple and bring our childhood trauma to our adult relationships. We forget about our responsibilities and start taking our partner for granted, and yet still expect that he or she will love us unconditionally. I have a great webinar entitled Obstacles to Love. I will leave the link in the description. There is a lot of valuable information in this webinar, so please watch it after this one. The unconditional love that we expect from our partners is in reality our cravings for the parental love that we did not receive enough of in our childhood. Parents love their kids unconditionally. They accept their bad behavior and keep loving them no matter what. Parents reassure their kid that they are always here for them. This is how healthy self-esteem and self-confidence is developed. When we do not get that reassurance in our childhood, we look for it in our romantic relationships. Because our partner cannot replace our mother or father, we feel that our needs are still not fulfilled. The pain that was hidden inside of us from our childhood is activated again. Now we have to block or suppress it somehow. Some of the easiest ways of dealing with the pain are eating, smoking, drinking, or doing drugs. Today's webinar is dedicated to overeating. The pleasure that we receive from eating food that we enjoy can be a perfect tool to suppress our emotions. We start eating more and more. When we eat, we feel better. Food eases the pain, but it can ease the pain only for a short period of time. Once the pain comes back, we need to eat again and again and again. This all happens subconsciously. Our brain substitutes one feeling for the other without us even being aware of it. When we feel sad, we want to eat something sweet that will make us happy. When we feel tired, we want to eat chocolate or candy to get energy. When a husband comes home angry after work, a wife can say, "Come down, honey, eat your dinner and relax." In this example, food is being used to suppress anger. Food helps us to deal with lack of love, with feelings of sadness, anger, anxiety, tiredness, and stress. Today we are talking about how food can compensate for the lack of love. We will discuss in detail how other emotions are connected to food on the next webinar entitled Food and Emotions. Tell me what you eat and I will tell you what problems you have. Please find the link to that webinar in the description of this video. If you like this video so far, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Please share this video on your social media with your friends and family members, with your partners, and with your loved ones. Let's get back to the topic. Why dieting doesn't work? Why people gain even more weight after dieting? Food is the easiest way to compensate for the lack of love. Therefore, if we did not receive enough love in our childhood and do not receive enough love now in our current relationship, then we will use food as our coping mechanism. When we have cravings for love and there is nobody who can give us enough love, care, enough support, we will use food as a substitute. Therefore, diet and exercise will never work alone. In our life, we possess several love containers. We receive one from each of our parents. One parent cannot fulfill the container of the other parent. For example, if your father was absent and your mother loved you unconditionally, this is still not enough. Your mother cannot replace the missing love for your father's container. Your partner, your children, your friends, or your pets cannot replace the missing love either. These are different types of love and different types of relationships. Often people try different diets and sport activities. They blame personal coaches and nutritionists for their failures. The truth is, if your inner love container is empty, diet and exercise won't help you to lose weight. A person with a strong willpower can lose weight, but if his psychological issues are not healed, then he will be drawn to food again. His willpower might falter in a stressful situation. Usually, when people do not receive enough love in their childhood, they will be drawn to toxic relationships later in life. Their psyche will look for a person with whom they can recreate their childhood scenario in hopes of finding a new outcome. So the woman who was abandoned by her father will be attracted to a man who does not love her. It can be a selfish person, a narcissist, or just an emotionally unavailable man. This woman will try to replay her childhood trauma and create a happy ending. But unfortunately, because she is attracted to a man who cannot love her back, she will be hurt again and again. In order to survive that pain, we need a tool that can help us to suppress our emotions. And food is one of the easiest ways of doing this. I've seen many clients who told me that they have moved past their childhood trauma. They don't have any resentment towards their parents, but they cannot control their eating. They know that they have eaten enough, but they still want more. This is a complex self-defense mechanism that is often hidden from us in our subconscious. The key of developing a healthy body and a healthy lifestyle is you must work on three important elements: on the psychological aspects of the problem, on developing an exercise routine, and on learning about healthy food and calories. What if you were raised in a loving family and still have food addictions? To answer this question, we have to talk about how the food addiction is developed. The first feeling of love we receive through breastfeeding. The baby's brain is not developed yet. All his receptors are concentrated in the mouth. He feels pleasure through the mouth. The breast milk is fatty and sweet, and we like food that is fatty and sweet. On the cellular level, when we want to feel love and experience pleasure, we are drawn to fatty and sweet food, completely unconsciously. This is the first reason why people who were raised in a loving family can still develop a food addiction. Because when we eat fatty and sweet food, we experience pleasure feelings inside of our mouth. When a baby is crying, the first thing that most mothers do is they feed the baby. If the baby does not eat, then the mother will think about other reasons why he is crying. The baby might cry because his pampers need to be changed, because his teeth are growing, because he was scared by a sudden noise, or because he was tired of lying down on his right side. But the common reaction of most mothers will be to feed the baby first. So the child is learning, no matter what is happening to me, the first thing I have to do is eat. And then I can deal with the situation. If I feel pain, I have to eat. If I feel discomfort, I have to eat. If I'm afraid, I have to eat. This is the second reason why people with a happy childhood might develop eating addiction. When we feel depressed, we want to eat sweet to feel happy. When we are stressed out, we want to eat to get energy. When we are angry or terrified of something, we want to eat to calm down. All our emotions are related to food. On the next webinar, I will talk in detail about food and emotions. People are addicted to different things. Some people are addicted to chocolate and sweets. Others are addicted to chips. Some are addicted to nuts. Although nuts are considered to be as a healthy snack, those people can eat lots of them and receive more calories than they need. On the next webinar, I will teach you about specific emotions and what types of food we use to substitute those feelings. We will talk about anger, loneliness, sadness, boredom, hidden aggression, and anxiety. If you want to watch that webinar about food and emotions, the link is below the video. By the time you watch this video, the other webinar should be already recorded and uploaded to YouTube. I prepared a series of 5 webinars about the psychological aspects of overeating. Today is the first one, Food as a Substitute of Love. The second one is Food and Emotions. Tell me what you eat and I will tell you what psychological problems you have. The third one is about people with an oral personality type. I am one of those people. I will tell you my personal story and you will learn about two types of dependency or two types of addictions, passive dependency and aggressive dependency. The fourth webinar is called Emotional Eating as a Universal Remedy for Better and for Worse. In order to understand how we are emotionally dependent on food, we will talk about how emotional eating is developed from the moment we were born through our childhood, teenage years, and into our adulthood. And finally, the fifth webinar will be about food and sexuality, how we use food to hide our sexuality. All links are below this video. Please watch all five webinars. Let's get back to today's topic, why people eat more than they need. Today we spoke only about the first reason, food as a compensation for lack of love. There is a total of 7 psychological reasons for overeating. If you like to learn all 7 reasons, then I'm inviting you to join my 12-week online course, Weight Loss Vaccine. This online course includes 12 weeks of deep internal healing. Every week you will work on a new topic and receive a new set of exercises. Consider this course as the 12 steps of healing your psychological aspects of overeating. This course is not about calories, diets, or exercises. This course is about understanding yourself on a deep level. You will understand what is causing your body to eat more than it needs and develop healthy ways of managing your appetite. As you already know, people use food to deal with their emotions, stress, and anxiety. In this course, we will go into detail about unfolding our unhealthy defense mechanisms and developing new reactions, new habits, and new beliefs. Don't let the food control you. Free yourself from emotional hunger and find the inner peace within. The breakdown of this online course you can view on my website. The link is below this video. And right now you can enroll for 50% off. Don't miss this opportunity. This is a limited time only. If this video was helpful, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I'm sure you have some questions. Please comment below the video. Again, my name is Elena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness. If you don't want to miss any of my future free self-development webinars, please join my newsletter. The link is also below the video. Please share this video on your social media, on your Facebook, on your Instagram. Share it with your friends, with your family members. And thank you very much for watching. Until next time, bye.